Like all of the solar system's gas giants, Uranus has an extensive system of moons. Of these, none are greater in size, mass, or surface area than Titania. One of the first moons to be discovered around Uranus, this heavily cratered and scarred moon was appropriately named after the fictional queen of the fairies. Titania was discovered by William Herschel on January 11, 1787. Nearly 200 years after its discovery, the Voyager 2 spacecraft flew by the Titania and found signs of that it was potentially geologically active. Finding a moon with so many large fault valleys surprised and delighted scientists. The crust breaks that are carried out in two directions indicate that Titania has some form of tectonic disruption. It has an orbital and rotational period that are both exactly 8.7 days. This means that like many of the moons, Titania is tightly locked, allowing only one side to face Uranus. Titania's diameter is 1,578 km and it is the largest of all of the moons of Uranus and the 8th largest moon in the entire solar system. Of the 5 major moons, it is also the 2nd farthest moon from its parent planet. Titania and Ariel appear quite similar, though Ariel is 25% smaller. Although it is the largest moon of Uranus, it is much smaller than Triton, the largest moon of Uranus' sister planet, Neptune. Titania is believed to be composed of about half water ice and half rocky material. It is very similar in composition to Ariel, but is much larger. Scientists believe that Titania's high density indicates that it was created either from the leftover debris when Uranus was first formed, or from the debris of a possible collision with Uranus that caused the tilt of the planet to its side. Scientists have observed Titania for a long time and theorized that it is composed of equal parts of ice and rock. The rock may include organic compounds and carbonaceous materials. Through the use of infrared spectroscopic observations from 2001 to 2005, the concept was later supported that Titania has an unusually high density for one of Uranus' moons. Well, the studies shows that the surface of Titania has crystalline water ice. Another observation is that scientists think that Titania may be different in that it has an icy mantle that surrounds a rocky core. The state of the icy mantle is not known. However, if the ice contains ammonia, this would act as an antifreeze and allow mushy or liquid water. If these conditions exist, then it gives an increased percentage that there is a layer of liquid ocean at the boundary of the core mantle. Experts estimate that if it exists, the ocean thickness would be around 31 miles or 50 kilometers. Titania's surface is a mixture of cratered, terrane, and systems of interconnected valleys hundreds of kilometers long. Some of craters appear to be half submerged. There is a huge canyon named Messina Chasma that extends 927 miles or 1,492 kilometers. The chasm begins at the moon's equator and stretches almost to its south pole. Titania's surface is clearly relatively young, though older than some such as Enceladus. Obviously, some sort of resurfacing processes have been at work. One theory of Titania's history is that it was once hot enough to be liquid. The surface probably cooled first. When the interior froze, it expanded, forcing the surface to crack and resulting in the valleys that we see today. Voyager 2 did flybys of Titania in 1986. The probe was only able to photograph 40% of moon's surface due to the darkened winter condition. Only 24% of the images were within precision required for geological mapping. Astronomers are using high-powered Earth-based and space telescopes to accomplish additional research on Titania. Like all the Uranus moons, much remains to be discovered about this most massive of her satellites. In the coming years, one can only hope that NASA, the ESA, or other space agencies decide that another Voyager-like mission is needed to send the outer solar system. Well, until such time, Uranus and the many moons that orbit it will continue to keep secrets from us. Thanks for watching Space Channel and wait for more informative documentaries. Bye-bye.